Good afternoon, Synergy. Let me start with thanking you for inviting us and giving us the opportunity, us is Damen, the opportunity to have a pitch here today. This pitch will be about Damen. Who is Damen? What is Damen? What is she doing? And then onwards to Damen in Duinkerke, which is the shipyard not far from here. And then what can we do and what can we contribute to the offshore industry on wind farms? So my name is Mark-Jan van den Akker. I'm the managing director, president, whatever you call it, in Duinkerke. What we see here is the proud vessel of DEME entering the port of Duinkerke onwards to our yard to be assisted in mobilizing for a project. What is Damen and what is she doing? Damen is a shipyard. Damen is now is 90 years old. It all started with a very small family business, and it really lifted off in the 60s when the present chairman of the company, Mr. Kommer Damen, took over, and he had a bright idea of standardizing and modularizing ships. And from there on, it took a jump into where we are today. The rest is history. We have 12,000 employees today, 36 yards on five continents. This is the latest acquisition that we've done last year in Romania. It's called the yard. Please help me out. But Mangalia, there you go. Thank you. So again, it's taken a flight over the last couple of years, and if you look at the world map, you see all the little dots where Damen is represented by either yards or offices or representations. On a yearly basis, we do on an average, 160 vessels a year. So, and over the last 70 years, we have produced 6,000 vessels. You can imagine, starting off as a small family company in the early years, it was only a couple of ships. So you can do the math yourselves. It's a huge amount of vessels that we produce on an annual basis. This is the proud yard in Duinkerke. We picked out this picture specifically because the sea installer is entering, and this is a ship used by DEME nowadays, because it's been taken over by DEME for the wind farm industry. She's entering our biggest dock. The dock is 300 meters long and 50 wide, basically. What the picture is saying is that we do 1,500 repair jobs in 50 dry docks all over the world. We have slipways, we have repair holes and lifts. Focusing on France, we have two yards, one in Duinkerke on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side is Brest. Brest is also represented. Jan is here, so if you have any question, please address it to Jan. The biggest difference between Brest and Duinkerke actually is geographically, obviously, but other than that, it has a big dock. I think the dock is, it says here, 420 meters long and 80 wide. So this dock can have the bigger vessels built in the world. They are focusing on LNG services and on nowadays on cruise. It's really booming, so they're doing great business over there. On the left-hand side, it's Duinkerke. We have two dry docks and one floating dock. We have ample berth, 900 meters of jetty, a huge workshop with gantry cranes. I'll show you a picture later on, so it gives you a bit more of an idea what it is all about. It has two gantry cranes, or more, multiple gantry cranes, but the biggest ones are 60 tons each, and they can work in tandem. So a huge lift capacity. And then we have, as a yard space, we have 10,000 square meters, which is ideal for mobilization, demobilization, storage, if you like, for temporary works, cradles, you name it. A picture of Brest, and you can see here the beautiful cranes. It's something to be envied about, because they have great cranes, better than we have in Dunkirk. And you see the cruise ship here being repaired by the yard. And then we have Dunkirk. As I told you, we have a floating dock. You see it here on the right hand side for you, left hand for me, and then the big dock, 300 by 50, and then all the way up in the right hand corner we have a smaller dock, 100 meters length, and then you see the quay sides with considerable depth, so we can have vessels with a draft up over 9 meters depth. A little history of the Dunkirk yard. It all started 70 years ago. This area, actually, in Dunkirk, was a booming business at the time in shipbuilding. It was new builds, it was repairs, conversions, anything. Unfortunately, we all know the history. Over time, the East became more and more competitive, and the area suffered big time. The only thing that is left is the yard that we have today. But the important thing here is that the knowledge has been retained, because it characterizes the people working on the yard, characterizes itself as a sort of a family, a type of way of working, because father and son, they all work in the yard, which gives the yard a special flavor. An impression of the workshop. I told you 22,000 square meters, and you see the gantry cranes over there. Ample room to do work preparation or inside building of huge structures. The type of work that we are specialized in is, you see here the mechanics, the mechanical people pulling a shaft here or pulling it back in. Then the steel constructions, painting, all done in-house. And this cannot be done without proper project management. So Mathieu and Dirk are making the plans here to make it a successful project. And all under the supervision of our safety department. Pauline and her colleagues are making sure that we do everything safe. This is the latest project that is on the go at the moment. We are actually in the finishing stage. We hope to redeliver the vessel in the next week. But it's been a challenge, and it's been a huge project. We worked on it for 1.5 years. And as you can see here, the whole engine room actually has been cut out and replaced. What you see here is the engine room. The old one is being taken out, and I'll show you a nice video that reveals how we did it.
C'est une remotorisation. On va découper le bateau, on va positionner des nouveaux moteurs sur un nouveau bloc machine.
Mettre les lingues côté opposé.
Bah en fait, ce sont de très grosses machines qui pèsent à peu près 50 tonnes, les moteurs. Question manutention, c'est vraiment à prendre avec précaution, sachant que le positionnement du moteur doit être très très précis sur le bloc.
Foot.
Le choix du motoriste MAN dans la réalisation de ce projet a été déterminant, notamment pour la performance de ces moteurs. Et c'est l'un des points majeurs qui nous a fait nous orienter vers cette motorisation-là.
Pour MAN, c'est un chantier important. En effet, on va installer trois moteurs dual fuel sur un ancien bateau. L'idée, c'est vraiment de baisser au niveau pollution, baisser l'émission des moteurs.
C'est une opération qu'on n'a jamais faite, ça.
Ah oui,
la première fois. Mais comment être aussi belle de ton côté? On va s'assurer de l'alignement correct en longitudinal et en transversal sur l'étoile de feu. Bon, ici, j'ai 140. À première vue, là, les formes, elles sont nickel. Il est là. Ça a été un bon boulot.
It gives me an enormous feel of pride when I look at this. It's been a great, huge project, together with MAN. Arlo Wijnse was our subcontractor for the electrical works. The vessel is now out just offshore Dunkirk doing the sea trials, and so far so good. So fingers crossed, and hopefully next week we'll be ready and ready to re-deliver it to the client. It's what I didn't tell you is that it's the first conversion of a dredger in Europe to LNG. So this is diesel, it's a dual fuel LNG, diesel LNG vessel. Quite special. Now to offshore wind, because that's why we are all here. What I'm trying to say here is that we have a yard with a lot of yard space. You can see that. I remind you, 10,000 square meters yard space, 22,000 square meters of workshop, and then the docks. But even if you don't have a dock, and I point out to the vessel Apollo, who is standing on his legs actually, with a big barge underneath, to do the work, even though it's not in dry dock. And this was a great, a big conversion, because we had to put a moon pool in it. We had to replace a tank. So it was quite some. We had quite some steel work that to do there, and we all did it outside a dock, sitting over a barge. So I think the message that I want to bring across today is that in our yard, especially when you look at the wind farms coming up in the on the west coast of France, in our yard, in our harbor, we are allowed to jack up these vessels without restriction. So this is the I think it's the Sea Challenger. She came in to as a makeover. Actually, she was bought by Dame May, and she needed a makeover. And we installed the spud shoes, the spud guns. On to more offshore wind activities. This is Damen design, Damen built, and it's our ambition and my ambition to bring this to Dunkirk and deliver it to the French industry, the west coast of France. Walk to work, we call it. It's a DP vessel built for BB Offshore. It's a walk to work vessel on DP with a heave compensated gangway. So it's very safe to bring your engineers to and fro the windmills and make sure that the people come back safely. Ooh. The last one, is the one we built for Van Oort. It's the cable layer. It's beyond my ambition. I think it's a good start to bring back to Dunkirk the new build of the smaller vessels, which is the crew transport vessels, tugboats, and that kind of types of little boats. So back for where we came from 70 years ago here in Dunkirk. But this is a bit beyond my expectation. So if you have any questions, please do not hesitate. Otherwise, thank you for your attention.